After breakfast, Katie and I kayaked toward shore. We had spotted a bear. Or was it a sea lion? Or, I don't know.
Seal over there. Oh, look at this big, nice seal. It has been as quiet as a rock.
Emily and they made a new friend, and they went kayaking also. Then Brennan and Troy came back from going bushwhacking. That's when Brennan tried to walk on water.
I haven't had a video going since. Stay long
enough to watch this. Yeah.
Okay.
Are you going to count of three?
One, two, three. One.
Come on,
you
go,
back. You get right out,
Three, two, one, go!
Oh. He wasn't gonna do it. Holy moly! Oh, it's salty. Okay, fancy him.
I didn't even think about that when I jumped.
Do it. How about number two times? I know. The hot tub's waiting for you guys. Oh, now Ben's brave. Now it's easy. Oh my gosh.
It was time to do some paddle boarding off the rear platform. Troy went first, carrying a big backpack. It turned out that he had brought a kite to try some kite boarding. He was too far away to get a clear picture, but it seemed to work okay. He's always trying different things like that. Oops, where did that picture come from? Ava and Emily had fun on the board.
Okay, anytime.
That is also when Emily had to show off her cheerleading form. All the kids on the boat had fun with this, and when I had a big surprise watching the big screen in the lounge when Dayton all of a sudden decided in front of the bow
there
camera go underwater.
Hey, there you go.
It was early Wednesday morning when we entered Glacier Bay National Park. There were already some ice floating from the Cavan glaciers up ahead. We were approaching the Grand Pacific Glacier, and off to the left is Marguerite.
Something's blocking.
Everyone had to have a look up there. This is also the spot where our family picture was taken. As the boat turned around and headed south, the details of the ice crevices became very clear. We were only a few hundred feet away from the face. We saw several sections calving into the bay, and it would be accompanied with a loud bang and a "oh" from the passengers. But of course, I never had the camera going at the right time. Large cruise ships need lots of room to turn around, and that's why they have to stay away a long way from some of the glaciers. Our boat passed this one as we got close to the John Hopkins Glacier. The park has issued several restrictions, such as a vessel could operate only one set of engines at a time. That was done to prevent lots of tenders being launched by the large cruise ships. But that rule also prevented us from launching our skiffs inside the park boundary.
Find a body or something?
Oh,
what is that?
It's on Brennan Line like this. I've never seen
it. But you know, you got a nice view from here, but you got
many times.
This is better, huh?
I like it better.
All right.
One of the crew members had grabbed this chunk of ice out of the bay, and now we had a contest to guess how long it would take for it to melt. Sharon was closest and won a bottle of wine. On the way out of the park, we docked at Bartley Cove and went ashore. A short hike took us by the lodge and this whale skeleton. And we then also took a hike along this trail.
Can you video?
Of course. Oh, here's Grandma.
Bear's bread fungi, which grows on all these trees. And they also call it artist fungi because this part
but it's
here
kind of like a lichen.
Black rock and right into, and they would make like little.
Oh, and make a design.
Oh. So it always grows facing down. The white part faces the ground. So when the tree falls, it always wants to turn. It ends up turning, so the white part faces down. Still.
Oh, I mean that.
There you go.
Hey, you're pretty smart about all of that.
Whoa. Ooh.
Look at that.
There. Snore time.
Very nice.
He's
sleeping. Found some sleeping giants under the tree.